Hey, in this video, I will tell you all about what is Cardano. If you spent even a day in the crypto markets, you've probably heard about Ethereum, the second largest cryptocurrency. Ethereum was created by a team of inspired individuals, among which the most well-known one is Vitalik Buterin. At some point, the initial Ethereum team broke up, and some members went on to create their own projects. One of those members was Charles Hoskinson, the now-known creator of Cardano. Before we get any further, I'd like to welcome you to Crypto Finally Explained, the most crypto-friendly educational YouTube channel for actually learning about crypto. Here, I finally explain crypto topics using simple animations, visual doodles, and real-life examples. In this video, I'll tell you all about what is Cardano. To be more specific, I'll introduce you to the history of the Cardano project, how it's different from other blockchains such as Ethereum, and what makes Cardano special in the first place. Let's go! To start this video off, we need to address the core question: what is Cardano? In order to answer this very question, allow me to continue with the story I've started in the introduction. The initial team behind Ethereum broke up because of a conflict of interest. Vitalik wanted Ethereum to remain a non-profit project, while team members such as Charles had the opposite point of view. He wanted Ethereum to start accepting venture capital and to become a for-profit project. Charles Hoskinson created Cardano with a single goal: to provide a more balanced and sustainable ecosystem for the cryptocurrency world. At its very core, Cardano is simply a cryptocurrency project named after an Italian mathematician. Just like many other crypto projects, it utilizes the proof-of-stake consensus algorithm, more on that later, and has a native coin called ADA. This is like you and your friend building a sandcastle on the beach, and having an argument on how many towers it should have. Since you can't come to a resolution, your friend decides to build a separate castle of his own, one with as many towers and gateways as he wants. The thing that makes Cardano special, and also different from other, similar blockchains, is the goal that the project has. There are three problems that Cardano aims to solve in regards to the crypto world: scalability, sustainability, and also interoperability. Big terms, but don't worry, let's break each of them down in a simple manner. Scalability is often named the biggest problem that all cryptocurrencies face. Put simply, it references the inability of blockchains to keep up with a growing user base, transaction speed-wise. Here's a simple example for you to understand what I'm talking about. Imagine that you're using traditional banking methods to pay for your online shopping. Let's say you have Visa. Your transactions are processed pretty fast, since Visa can handle up to and around 24,000 different transactions per second. However, every once in a while, you might experience lag spikes if the network is over-encumbered. If there are tens of thousands of other people buying something at that point in time, using Visa, you might need to wait for a few minutes for your transaction to be approved. Blockchains experience the same issue. However, they also have notoriously small block sizes. In other words, many of the older blockchains can't handle even close to the numbers of transactions that Visa can per second. Ethereum is no exception. It can only deal with around 15 transactions per second. So, Cardano aims to address and solve this problem. Specifically, the plan that Charles and the team behind Cardano have is to make it like this: the more users join the network, the faster it gets. Sounds awesome, doesn't it? However, how is this achieved? Well, as I've mentioned earlier in the video, Cardano works on a proof-of-stake consensus algorithm. It's a ginormous topic in of its own, so I highly advise you to go check out my video on staking if you want to understand it better. For the sake of keeping things simple in this video, basically, the Cardano network has validators, individual people or organizations, that confirm transactions happening on the blockchain. The thing that makes Cardano different from other proof-of-stake networks, however, is Ouroboros. This is a special type of a system made of epochs — currently these are periods of 5 days, and slots, 1 second intervals. Each slot has a slot leader, who is selected from the transaction validators, and this leader is chosen to confirm transactions. Right, all of that is, admittedly, extremely technical. I won't be going deeper into the topic, since it's so vast that it requires a different video of its own. For now, suffice to say that the Ouroboros system allows the Cardano network to be much more secure than your traditional proof-of-stake blockchains, which then allows an increase in scalability. Having dealt with that complicated can of worms, let's move on to something that's much simpler to understand: sustainability. In terms of Cardano, and cryptocurrencies in general, this means two things: how eco-friendly a project is, and just how likely it is to prosper and maintain its functionality long-term. Ecology-wise, Cardano's proof-of-stake system allows it to be much more eco-friendly than cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin or Ethereum. While it's still not ideal, Cardano is already leaps ahead of the two aforementioned coins when it comes to energy preservation and ecology concerns. Now, project longevity-wise, the situation is kind of the same too. Cardano has a dedicated treasury. It's filled up with transaction fees, and then those fees are paid out in the form of rewards to anyone who makes a meaningful impact on the ecosystem — developers, scientists, and so on. On top of that, Cardano is actually really big on science and long-term planning in general. There's a popular internet meme that, in order to make something happen on Cardano, you need to write a research paper on the subject and have it peer-reviewed by other blockchain professionals. While it is funny, it does showcase that Cardano is purely based on scientific research and advanced maths. Continuing on with the video, at some point in time, Charles Hoskinson agreed on a collaboration with another co-founder of Ethereum, Jeremy Wood. This collaboration resulted in a brand new company called IOHK, also known as Input Output Hong Kong. Cardano is the main point of interest for IOHK, and the company itself is concerned with creating blockchain solutions for both private companies as well as governmental institutions worldwide. All of that is to say, Cardano is already a well-established project with multiple backers, a company standing behind it, and huge plans for the future. Charles himself hosts frequent live streams right here on YouTube in order to answer questions that the community might have and to talk about the future of all things Cardano. Now, interoperability is another big issue that blockchains of today are dealing with. In order to understand what the term actually means, allow me to give you an example. Imagine that you're in a car and are driving down the road. You're going to check out another car. Perhaps you want to buy it. Or maybe simply meet a friend that drives a different car brand. At some point in your journey, you come across a river that needs to be crossed. No matter if you drive a sports car, a truck, or a tractor, you won't be able to cross that river without a bridge. Blockchain interoperability is that bridge. To throw it back to our topic at hand, different blockchains need to have some sort of a bridge where they could communicate with each other. If a blockchain lacks interoperability, it means that it doesn't have any cross-chain functionality, and you can only interact with its own native projects and applications. Cardano solves this issue with what is known as the KMZ Sidechains Protocol. It acts as the bridge between two blockchains. Thanks to the protocol, users are able to trade Cardano coins, or to be more specific, ADA coins, for other cryptocurrencies. So then, up to this point in the video, we've discussed what is Cardano and how this blockchain network is different from most other cryptocurrency projects out there. As you might have figured out by now, it truly is special. What does the future hold for Cardano though? And what does the community think about it? Well, for starters, it's worth pointing out that Cardano has a really, really strong community behind it. On one hand, this is amazing. It means that the project is strong and healthy and that there is avid interest in it from a large number of people. On the flip side though, it's also worth mentioning that there are criticisms of Cardano that relate to this very fact. Some people claim that the project has basically become a Charles Hoskinson cult, with fans cheering every single word that he says. Furthermore, this then evolves into criticism that any progress made on the network developments is very slow, and that there are only unrealistic ideas being thrown around without any signs of them being successfully implemented. What's the reality though? Well, in my honest opinion, Cardano is truly an amazing project with exponential potential. Sure, it does have some struggles, but this is true with any and all blockchains that you might evaluate and examine. At the same time, it's also important to mention that, contrary to popular belief, Cardano isn't an enemy of Ethereum. Instead, Charles has expressed multiple times that he feels that blockchains should work together in order to build a better tomorrow and not muscle up against each other on which of them has better scalability or smaller transaction fees. That being said, I do also have to point out that Cardano and Ethereum are still very different from one another. While Ethereum is often praised as the core technology behind the development of Web3, on which I have a separate dedicated video by the way, Cardano aims to work with governments and large organizations that are concerned with managing identity, value, and governance, as pointed out by Charles himself. With all of that being said, thank you so much for watching this video. I do hope that you've learned a lot. Also, I really hope to see you in my next video.